My name's Donny. I'm a singer, songwriter, producer, and mentor based in the UK. And we're just trying to keep soul alive. Since the Natural album, which was the last time I got interviewed on Icarus, I've had a breakup with like private life stuff happening, which kind of made me pen most of the tracks on the Little Star album that came out after it. The Little Stars did pretty well when it came out last summer. It was number one for like 3 weeks on the soul charts and stuff, so I was pretty chuffed about that. That was good stuff. But since then, I've done another album after that called Future Rare Grooves. I've been touring with Grace Jones. I've been writing with The Collective, which features me, Junior, Omar, Rick Clark, Paul Johnson, Lee John, Noah McCoy. It's like the Avengers of UK soul. Also working with a guy called Brian Eno, who was a musical genius, and did a Jules Holland show with him as well. So lots of stuff happening. So Future Rare Grooves was born after I finished Little Star. The album had already been submitted. It was out, it did what it did. It was number one for 3 weeks. And then the guys at Soul Soulful, they rang me up and said, yo, I need a song from you for this compilation album we're putting out. We want to promote, you know, all the independent artists. But I'd already submitted my song. So I was sitting there listening to some Rare Grooves, just chilling in the studio, really. And I heard some music, a piece of music that didn't have any singing on it. And I thought, rather than me wrap my brain now, let me just sing on top of what I'm hearing, because what I'm hearing sounds dope to me. It just needs to be sort of 21st century-ized. So I kind of just like, you know, reprogrammed some drums on top of it, kind of a West Indian style, dirty, you know, two-step bass line, and a track called Feeling You was born.
So don't walk away, no. And there's too much in my street. Sit in between, hey. You and me. Can't you be the energy? So give it a try, anything you want to.
And if you don't try, yeah,
then you won't know. Never know how much I'm feeling you, baby.
And I started getting calls saying, this song that you've done is getting loads of rewinds in the dance and there's great reaction from DJs. And I'm like, really? Okay. And that's, I mean, Little Star did good, but this is kind of getting a lot of love. So I thought, oh, man, let me check this out kind of thing. So my mate said he's doing a party or that he's DJing somewhere, that I should go to this party. So I went to the party and he said, when I drop the tune, you'll see what happens. So when he dropped the tune out, he must have to pull the tune back 5 times. It was like, boop, 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 boop. You know what I mean? So I was like, okay, is that what you lot want? This, like, I created that in like, wasn't long. Like, usually it takes me a little while to bust a tune, but these ones were like, it's already built, innit? So you just have to just vibes on top of it, put something that is just like, you know, that'll nice it up. So I thought, okay, I'm going to go away and do a project called Future Rare Grooves. I knew it was a bit soon after Little Star, but I thought, you know, if they're buzzing on this, and me, how I like to make music already. Again, I just sat there and just listened to Rare Groove tracks that I, you know, moved me back in the day kind of thing. Classic ones, and just, like I said, redone the drum, played the bass on top, new guitars on things, harmonies. Natasha Watts came down and she blessed the Big People's Team's track. Wrote her verse and everything, and I lived with it for about a week and a half and then dropped mine afterwards. So yeah, Future Rare was born then. Then I heard, oh, my mate was in Shepherd's Bush. He said he'd just come from Shepherd's Bush or something. He was like, oh yeah, I just heard your tune, man. It sounds bad, man. I love the Big People Team's, man. Let's go back and get one of them CD. And I was like, okay, well, so that's interesting, because I never made no CDs. Yeah, I didn't make any, so basically a man must have bootlegged my album, and stuck it out there. People were buying CDs. I was like, okay, I'm going to have to look at this positive. So I said, okay, my man's giving me free promotion. Whoever it is, you know, it's free promotion, isn't it? So I then went and, because people were ringing me up asking for physical copies because I only did digital. It was only on MP3, on CD Baby, iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, all of that. So basically, they found that they downloaded the songs and did their own version. So I thought, right, I'll do my own physical copy with an extra hidden track on the end of it, which is going like hotcakes right now. So I'm really chuffed because there's no label involved. It's just Donny Music, you know what I mean? So it's kind of, it's nice. The rewards are great, and yeah, I think it feels good as well when you've actually put in all the work, and then you can see the results, and like radio's playing your stuff, and you kind of cut the middleman right out, which is nice now and again. Not saying that I wouldn't sign a deal again or something, as long as I can still make the music and keep my artistic integrity, as it were. But right now it's all good, independent is the way.
You want something that's real? Well,
this one hits the spot.
A little that feel.
This one hits the spot.
Come on, let's get a deal, yeah.
This one hits the spot.
There's no spinning the wheel.
This one hits the spot.
See where I am. Be the man to make the change in your life. I got a plan, not just a bet. Got everything you want right here. Yeah.
She be looking for the real thing.
Want it, I got it.
She wanna get that feeling.
Want it, I got it. Yeah.
See, she be missing that moment.
Want it, I got it. Yeah.